the language work, but it's like a slash through 50 years. So you see, well, I'll say it again, metaphorically, you see a kind of bit of brain, you see a bit of foot, a bit of shirt, and you just continue through a slice through art and language history, which is really interesting to me because you suddenly are confronted with work which has a kind of, sometimes a similar title. There are a lot of works out there that are called, there are some works out there that are called indexes, and one of these works there will be one index which is basically just text, and there will be another index which is in fact a painting. So this, what I call a slice through the history of art and language, has thrown work together which should be seen together, but because of the way the art world classifies things, it always separates. You know, we have conceptual art, and then, ooh, we have painting, and it's got nothing to do with conceptual art, and there's one style and another style. Well, I mean, in a way, this collapses styles. What happens up there is there's a kind of collapse of style, which I think is something that Michael and I have been messing around with and trying to kind of get to for a very long time.
You've managed, for example, to show that when we produce paintings or things like that, we often also produce infrastructures around them, so that, you know, you've bothered to put the Red Crayola, play the music of the Red Crayola, or you've also shown the redescription, as it were, of the artist's studio genre in the form of the two old men talking about Red Crayola music and rendering their speech articulate. You put in all those infrastructural margins, which is essentially what we've always tried to do, because the essence, if there is an essence, and I'm sure it is, of the work is it a kind of redescription or translation, where one work in the context of a discursive framework, a social framework, will often get re-described. In being re-described and so on, it will often be betrayed, and in that betrayal, one starts embarks upon another essay. And that's the point. Art and language is an essayistic re-describing practice, and you have brought that character insofar as Philippe's collection is capable of supplying the material to do it. You've brought that out. That's how I feel about it.